You know, when kids come into life with these past life memories, it's usually for a reason. It's usually because there's some unresolved pain or something that they didn't finish.
Hear the fascinating story of a mother and son who recall their past life together, up next.
Treasured friends, today we are honored to present part two of a two-part series entitled Remembering Past Lives, Baseball Prodigy Christian Haupt, with Miss Solange Mora from Samara in Nicoya, Costa Rica. Miss Mora has a love of education and many years of experience in teaching children and the disabled. She has a bachelor's degree in the art of education from the National University of Costa Rica, and certifications in Braille and early childhood development. In Costa Rica, she worked with blind high school students and adults at the Helen Keller Institute and helped them to be more independent. She has also traveled to different areas of Costa Rica with a diverse working team of social workers, psychologists, and teachers to help to enhance the quality of life of the visually impaired. Since coming to the U.S., Ms. Mora has taught preschool and primary school children. She is currently a teacher at Bambini Montessori in Nashville, Tennessee, teaching students ages 3 to 6 using the Montessori method of education, which celebrates and nurtures each child's intrinsic desire to learn.
Hola, amados televidentes. Soy Solange Mora de Samara en Nicoya, Costa Rica. El pueblo costarricense está orgulloso en la forma en que defienden el amor y el perdón. En el programa de hoy, continuaremos aprendiendo acerca de Christian Haupt, el niño prodigio jugador de béisbol, quien recordaba que en su vida pasada era el muy admirado primera base de los Yankees de Nueva York, Lou Gehrig. En el programa de hoy, la madre de Christian, Kathy Baird, explica qué sucede con un niño que puede tener recuerdos de una vida pasada, cómo afectan estos recuerdos al niño a medida que crece, y qué consejo tiene ella para otros padres con niños así.
So there is a pattern with these children who recall past life memories. There's a high incidence of boys versus girls, and there's also a pattern between the lives that are remembered are generally lives that were cut short, either due to illness or accidents, kind of a traumatic death. It's a life that's unfinished. You know, almost when you wake up from a dream and you go back and you start dreaming the same dream. And really, when you look at it, this amnesia that we're born with is such a gift because we can go into this lifetime unencumbered by memories of a past lifetime, right? So now that Christian's 9 years old, he's very much, you know, himself. When we go to his baseball tournaments, we're not saying like, go Lou Gehrig. You know, like it's not something we think about every day. It's something that's sacred to us and important and special, but it doesn't interfere with his ability to live his life in this lifetime. One of the big messages is to listen to our children, and children have so much wisdom that I feel sometimes we get further away from as we get older. So I really encourage parents to listen to what kids are saying. That was the biggest thing that Carol Bowman and Jim Tucker taught me, was not to be scared by it, not to be dismissive, but just to let the children speak and not to be probing them. That's the last thing you want to do, is start fishing for details, but just listening and asking objective questions and letting it come out so they're not embarrassed and they're not ashamed. And it does provide closure and healing. You know, when kids come into life with these past life memories, it's usually for a reason. It's usually because there's some unresolved pain or something that they didn't finish.
Cuando Christian era un niño, le dijo a Kathy que ella también fue su madre cuando él fue Lou Gehrig. Además, dijo que mientras él estaba en el cielo, eligió a Kathy para ser su madre. ¿Por qué Lou y Cristina deciden regresar al mundo como madre e hijo?
So one of the questions he asked me when I was under hypnosis was, what was the purpose of Lou and Christina coming back in this lifetime as you and Christian? And the answer that I gave was to relive the good times. So it was really an amazing message, because if we look at it as like, okay, we choose to come into this world, we choose our parents, we want to be in these physical bodies so that we can enjoy the pleasures of life, right? The things that if you're in spirit form, you can't eat an ice cream cone or swim in the ocean or hold the hand of a child, you know, these physical sensations, you know, loving people, connecting with people. So it really kind of changes my view on life in general, and life is a choice.
Tomaremos un momento para agradecer a la divinidad por nuestra vida aquí en la tierra. Volveremos justo después de este mensaje. Bienvenidos de nuevo al episodio final de Recordando Vidas Pasadas. El prodigio del béisbol, Christian Haupt. Mientras continuamos nuestra charla con Christian Haupt y su madre, Kathy Baird. La señora Baird recientemente escribió un libro titulado El chico que sabía demasiado, acerca de los recuerdos de la vida pasada de su hijo y el viaje espiritual que siguió. ¿Cuáles son los mensajes principales en este libro?
So really the themes in the book are listening to our children, following our intuition, and really enjoying each day that we're blessed with. And the thing that really drove me to write the book was this message of unity. The fact that our souls survive death, and that love can surpass one lifetime. So really, if we can begin to see each other as souls within a body, rather than as these bodies that we physically represent, we can really have a lot more compassion for each other and really less judgment. And I think that's really something that's needed in the world today.
The main reason of the book is to make other people be nice to other people, no matter what color of skin they have, whether if they have a disabled body, and you should just be nice to other people.
And I was afraid, you know, I didn't want people making fun of him at school and saying, oh, you think you were someone else, you're crazy. But I've been shockingly and amazingly surprised that everyone has been very lovely about it. We've made it very clear that our message is not to convince people of reincarnation. Really what came through this whole experience, and everyone that reads my book really gets it, is what came through is proof that our souls survive death. You know, and really the message in the book is that love can surpass one lifetime. And so that's really what inspired me to write the book. And even Christian and Charlotte are on board with the message. They know that we did it for a bigger reason, bigger than ourselves. And if people do make fun of us, it's okay. You know, we know that, you know, we're doing our job to just get the story out there and the message for the higher good.
El libro de Kathy, El chico que sabía demasiado, fue publicado en el 2017 y ya ha tocado muchos corazones. Fue un libro de los más vendidos en Amazon.com y fue el ganador del Grand Prize en el 2017 en el Festival del Libro de San Francisco y ahora ha inspirado una película con el mismo nombre.
So, 20th Century Fox and producer Devon Franklin optioned the movie rights. Devon did the movies Heaven is for Real and Miracles from Heaven with Jennifer Garner. And they're hoping to go into production in 2018.
Cuando los niños que pueden recordar vidas pasadas crecen, ¿qué les sucede? ¿Retienen los recuerdos de sus vidas anteriores? Christian y Kathy comparten sus experiencias de esto.
Apart from playing baseball, do you remember anything else from that previous lifetime?
Not anymore, really, but when I was little, I would tell stories to my mom every night before I went to bed, and then they start fading away when you become like 7 or 8, when you become older.
So most of these kids that have the past life memories, it starts around the age of 2 or 3, and it dissipates between 6 and 7 years old. And with Christian, he very much followed that pattern. He was around, I want to say he was close to 6, when he said, "Mommy, it's hard for me to remember now because God gave me a new brain." And that's really the way that it happened. It was almost like when you wake up from a dream and at first you can kind of remember it and then it just disappears and you can't recall. That's exactly how it happened.
Otras familias pueden encontrarse en una situación similar, donde un niño de 2 o 3 años empieza a describir una vida pasada. ¿Cuál es el consejo de Christian para los padres de niños así?
I think that parents should listen to their child when they start talking about weird stuff like past life memory. And yeah. If I met a kid today, I would tell them to like, don't be scared or nervous. And just say your story that you have.
Teniendo en cuenta lo que saben acerca de Christian y sus recuerdos de la vida pasada, ¿qué creen que este joven quiere ser cuando crezca?
When I grow up, I want to be a baseball player. I still play a lot of other sports right now, like soccer and basketball, and I like it most a lot, but I want my main sport to be baseball growing up.
El libro de Kathy Baird, El niño que sabía demasiado, una historia verdadera asombrosa de los recuerdos de la vida pasada de un niño, está disponible en Amazon.com. Iluminados televidentes, gracias por su compañía hoy para el episodio final de Recordando Vidas Pasadas, el prodigio del béisbol, Christian Haupt. A continuación sigue Alimentos Pacíficos y Amorosos, parte 5 de 6, en Entre la Maestra y los Discípulos. Que sus vidas estén llenas de dicha, en tanto cumplen la misión de su vida con sabiduría y nobleza. Enlightened viewers, thank you for your company today for the concluding episode of Remembering Past Life. Baseball prodigy Christian Haupt. Coming up next is Peace and Loving Foods, part 5 of 6 on Between Master and Disciples. May your life be filled with joy as you fulfill your life mission with wisdom and nobility. For more details, please visit SupremeMasterTV.com/SS.